Hey guys, how are you all? My name is Harshi Devedi, friends, and I welcome you back to my video. So in this video, in a very short amount of time, I'm going to tell you that how many type of coral reefs are there. See friends, three type of coral reefs are there. First is the fringing shore reef. Second is the barrier reef. And third is atoll reef. Okay, so these three types of reefs I will be discussing in this video, friends. Before starting with this video, I would like to tell you that if you want to watch the Hindi version of the video, the link of that is given in the description box below. Also, if you want to follow me on Instagram, friends, the link of that is also given below. Friends, you can also subscribe to me on YouTube. So friends, before watching this video, a video on corals is given in the description box below, so please watch that corals video so that the basics of coral would be clear to you. Also, a video on coral bleaching, the link is also given below, you can also watch that so that corals as a whole will be clear to you. Now, what are reefs and how reefs develop? See friends, this is beach and now the sea starts. Now what normally happens that when the sea starts, first continental shelf comes, then continental slope comes, and then deep sea plains come. Here what is happening when the sea is starting, here you can see a reef crust has developed. So basically, what is happening that the graph is something like this. Okay, the depth is not increasing, after some time the depth has come upwards. So this reef crest has developed. And you will see that on this side of the reef crest, immediately the depth will increase because deep sea is there. So basically, coral formation will not be on this side because the depth is increasing suddenly. The coral formation will be here on the top and on this side. You can also see that these small things, friends, these small, upwards coming structures, these upwards coming structures, when they will come on the surface of the water, they will look something like this. These type of structures, friend, if you have ever taken a flight out of Mumbai or out of a coastal area, for example, if you have ever taken flight from, you can say, Mumbai to Maldives, so in that case, when you will be entering the ocean, you will be seeing this type of structures. Or you have taken a flight from Andaman and Nicobar Island, so whenever you are entering a sea, you will see these type of structures. Basically, what are these? These are fringing reefs. These are shore reefs. These shore reefs are directly emanating from the shore. You can say that this is basically these structures which are coming out of the sea floor. Okay, and when they come out of the sea floor, they will look something like this. You can see that below the water there is reef also. This part has not come over the water. The part that has come above the water, a lot of tree formation is there. So basically, this will become a sort of small islands. So this is what is fringing reef. It is very near to the land. It is around 1 to 2 kilometers in. Its length is around 1 to 2 kilometers. So this is basically fringing reef, friends. And in between the land and the reef, there will be a shallow lagoon. For example, the lagoon in this case is this one. This is a shallow lagoon between this reef. Also, friends, these islands, these are small, upward projections. The main reef structure is this. This is the main reef structure. And because of this main reef structure, small amount of coastal islands are coming outside, which will be visible like this. This is there, this is there, this is there. Okay, so now you will be able to understand what this fringing reef is, friends. In the whole world, fringing and shore reefs are the most common type of reefs which are available in front of us, friends. Now coming to the next reef, what is barrier reef? Barrier reef is quite big, friends. What is happening in a barrier reef? Suppose, in order to understand barrier reef, suppose this is land. This side is land and that side is ocean. Now in the ocean, parallel to the coast, if for hundreds and thousands of kilometers a group of islands and group of coral islands are standing continuously, so basically this will form a combined barrier reef. So barrier reefs are actually hundreds and thousands of kilometers long and they run parallel to the coast. However, their, you can say, their structure may be haphazard. The structure may be very irregular, but yes, they will run parallel to a coast. So basically, this will be a barrier reef. One example of this barrier reef is that you can see here, friends. This is the Great Barrier Reef of Australia. On the northeast coast of Australia, parallel to the northeast coast of Australia, a long, complex set of reefs have, for 1200 miles, this reef is extending. This length is around 1200 miles. So for 1200 miles, this reef is extending on the northeast coast of Australia. So this becomes the Great Barrier Reef, friends. Okay. Got my point? Now, this Great Barrier Reef, or you can say the Barrier Reef, these Barrier Reefs, they are not very common. They are very uncommon, friends. Okay, we don't see many, Barrier Reefs in the world. Yeah, Barrier Reefs are seen, but the most common type of reefs are Fringing Reefs and Shore Reefs. Barrier Reefs are less common. Coming to the third part, Atoll Reef. I will come to this diagram a bit later. This is Atoll Reef. Have a look at this thing. Atoll Reef are not very much close to the shore, and they are also not in very deep sea ecosystems. In areas conducive where the sea is not very deep, structures like this will come upwards. And in that case, you can see this red portion, this much amount of red portion. Okay, just focus on the portion that I made red. This much amount of red portion has come very much close to the ocean surface. Now, the conditions in this red portion, the circular red portion, they are very much conducive for the development of reefs, the corals. So basically, corals can be developed here. So in this case, three types of atolls will form. One is true atoll. In this true atoll, the circular structure will remain below the water, and circular reef is there, obviously, but obviously the corals are here, but these corals are not exposed to the surface. This is a circular reef, and in between there is a lagoon. This lagoon has water. In the second case, what will happen, that this circular red portion will be exposed to the atmosphere, and when it will be exposed to the atmosphere, it will look something like this, friends. Now here, the inside reef has been exposed to the air, and when it has been exposed to the atmosphere, you will see that it has sort of formed an island. In this island, you can see a lot of trees has developed. So basically, a sort of small island has formed because that coral reef has come out of the ocean water. So this is the second type. In third type, what will happen? That enhanced process of erosion will be there because of the waves process. The waves will lead to more deposition of silts, because you can see here, friends, more waves are coming, they're depositing more and more silt. Here also silt is being deposited, and that is why the extent of the land area of this island, that will increase. So in that case, an island formation will be enhanced. So that will become the third type of atoll. So basically, three type of atolls will be formed. This lagoon in between, initially it has a depth of 80 to 150 meters, and it is connected to main sea through some channel so that it can get its regular supply of water. Okay, if we talk about some example of atolls in the world, friend. So some example of atolls, you can find the Lakshadweep. There are a lot of atolls in the Lakshadweep island. Then, friends, many atolls are present in South Pacific Ocean. You need to understand this. In South Pacific Ocean, some examples of atolls that I will be telling you, they are French Polynesia. If you take the world map, you are going to follow this. French Polynesia is an example of atoll island. Then Marshall Island is an example of atoll island. Then Micronesia, it is an example of atoll island. Then Cook Island. Cook Island is also an example of atoll island. So this is in basically Pacific Ocean, specific South Pacific Ocean. When we talk about Indian Ocean, in Indian Ocean, the atolls are also there. Where? Maldives. Then this is also an atoll island, friends. Then Chagos Archipelago. Have you heard about Chagos Archipelago? Chagos Archipelago is a disputed territory currently under the control of British. Mauritius is claiming it. So Chagos Archipelago also comes under this group of atolls, the Coral Island. Then Seychelles comes under this group. Then Cocos Island groups comes under this group, friends. So basically, these are some examples of atolls. So I hope this atoll has become clear to you. All three types of coral reefs, that is the fringing and shore reef. This is the most common all over the world. Then second is the barrier reef. Barrier reef is the least common all over the world. And third is the atoll reef. Atoll reef is also common. Not as common as the fringing and shore reef. And not so much less as the barrier reef. So I hope these three types of reefs are clear to you. How they form, that is also clear to you. So before stopping with this video, friends, I would like to tell you that the Hindi version is available. You can find the link below. Also, if these videos are helpful for you, friends, I will request you to like this. Like these videos. You can subscribe to my channel. You can share these videos with your friends. If you find them useful, you can share them with your friends. Okay, and please subscribe there, and you can follow me on Instagram, friends. So thank you for watching, friends. Have a great day. Please share these videos on my social media profile. Keep studying.